My name is Shireen Kataria. I'm from New Delhi, India. I'm 20 years old and I just completed my undergraduate last month. I was studying commerce over there, and right now I'm actually working with the Sports Authority of India. I've always been a sports person, so I'm in the research team in the Sports Authority of India right now. I think, you know, everybody has an idea before we come to such a conference. We're thinking about our own nation, we're thinking about how things work over there and how we can improve. But when we come together in such a conference and we get a chance to communicate with each other, we get a chance to listen to other nations' problems, the challenges they're facing, the perspectives they have, and the opportunities or the positive sides that they want to contribute, I think it really opens each and everybody's mind, and the points that they come with before the summit, they actually multiply, and you have a better perspective of the entire world. So when before I came here, I was thinking about how, like, the challenges that India has, how can we improve those, and my perspectives about that. But right now I'm actually thinking about the challenges that the world has, how can we improve those together, and how can we help each other to make this world a better place. India has it's very diverse. It has a huge population and it is very diverse. So we have the urban sector and we have the rural sector. The urban sector has been developing and we do get education, and I'm very privileged that, you know, I have got a chance and the opportunity to get education, to give my views, to have my own thinking. But it is not the same in the rural sector. They do not have the infrastructure to even, I mean, it's changing right now, but they don't have the infrastructure, the things that you require to get a complete education and to be developed overall. So there's a disparity. So in the urban sector, you get a lot of opportunities. There are people who go abroad to, study or maybe work abroad, or work abroad but contribute to the Indian economy. But in the rural sector, there are not a lot of opportunities for the labor because they do not know what all options do they have. They are living in a cocoon and they are living in this bubble which needs to be broken so that they know that in the future there are a lot of other things that we can do. There are a lot of other things that the world has for us. What I've chosen is education because I can relate to it, and I think education is the base, and the pyramid is built on that base. When you have education, when you know the power of education, you know how everything is actually integrated and they're all working together, they're all interconnected. But education is that one link that you have to connect to those different forces. And what I think is that for education, like, you know, right now everybody is really focusing on the soft skills. They're focusing on how to be more creative, how to be more how to collaborate, how to communicate. And that is because when you're creative, you think of ideas for these goals, for sustainable development, for future of work, for entrepreneurship, how to make these task forces better, how to make them bigger. And the new ideas that you get is through education. You be creative and you provide more ideas on how can we be more sustainable, how do we, the job scenario is completely changing. We have new jobs coming in the future which are not even present today. How to tackle that, or how can we fulfill those jobs, and how can we create more jobs so that the unemployed people are employed. So I think education is a very important link that connects everything, and everything becomes better when you have that link. I think we need to come together, brainstorm, and come up with maybe a set of other case studies or projects that can be replicated in the various nations by the youth. The youth, the main problem is that they do not have enough, I mean, they have power, yes, but we need to reach to that power. We need to make sure that it's going in a right way, and we have a lot of ideas, but those ideas need to be heard and implemented in the right way that we're thinking. So I think it is important to engage everybody to make projects that can be scalable, that can be adjusted according to their needs, and a way on how they can implement it and make it better in their respective nations, and how to reach those authorities who have the power to change on real ground. We can give them ideas, we can be advisors, we can, instead of quantity, I think we should focus on quality, on how we make maybe not so many recommendations or not so many projects, but those few projects that are actually not only scalable in the developed countries or the first world countries, but also in the developing or underdeveloped countries. Right now, the underdeveloped countries, people don't talk about it. People talk about the developing or the developed countries. What about the underdeveloped countries? How are we going to be more sustainable if we don't pick up each and everybody together and lift up? Like, we can't have that graph where one is going up and one is going completely down. I think everybody has to rise to a level where they're all equal and create that environment.